So one thing just to say in the context of many people listening today, you're thinking about what am I going to do in my next relationship? But a big thing you can take away from this whole series is, what were the mistakes I made in my past relationship? Because it is a cliche, but it's cliches are often true, which is before you can really have a loving relationship, you have to love yourself. Mm-hmm. And statistically, women after a painful breakup, after a divorce, will be 9 years before they get involved again, if they get involved. For a man, it's 3 years. Women have bigger trust issues. You know, I really went for this guy. I love this guy, and he turned out to not work out. How can I trust myself again?
Yeah.
That becomes a hard thing. And one of the ways to trust yourself again is to, you know, take to heart everything I've said, is that women don't understand men and men don't understand women. And it's really about learning how to communicate our needs and our wishes in a way where a man can hear it, and then we can get what we need. Because when we don't get what we need, if you're a woman and you're not getting what you need in a relationship, you'll bring out the worst in a man, because a man thrives when he feels, I can give you what you need. So there's an art, as I've been sort of exploring, how to communicate yourself to a man, how to interact with a man so that he feels successful and providing for you. And part of that, as I said a minute ago, is not making him provide for your happiness. He's there to make you happier. That's a really optimistic message today. we want to be more positive in our relationships, and we can do that when we're not overly dependent on each other. So what, to be on your estrogen side, women, you want to be dependent on him for only so much. And then there's so many other things that you can depend on for your happiness and your fulfillment in life, so that the world doesn't end if he disappears. You know, even though we all want to be the most special to each other, there's no doubt about that. But at the same time, the foundation of being so special to your partner, help him feel he can be successful. And that only is the case if you find a fulfillment inside yourself and you're also looking for more. There's kind of an attitude from our past relationships that have failed. And that's why, to build trust to move on, if you recognize that you weren't fully a victim, but you were part of it, you see, you're part of the problem. And I know partners can be horrible to each other, and we often don't see our side of it. And we often justify our side of the horrible by you were first, but you did it first.
And mm-hmm. That's why keeping score.
Keeping score is also a thing that happens, but also just not understanding how you unknowingly sabotage a relationship. You know, a really sophisticated skill for a woman in a relationship is to never complain. And then the first thing women go, yeah, but how can I change him? I go, well, first, you picked him, don't change him. But I know what you mean is, how can I get more? And you can get more by bringing more out of him. And it's common sense that people become more when they feel loved and appreciated, and you ask for help and they do it. And so it's like a whole art of how to ask for help and get it, how to provide the foundation where you can ask for more. Because if you don't already feel like you're getting a lot and you ask for more, it's kind of like, I'm already doing my best. How could you want more? And so you have to always get the message that what they're providing for you is enough, and this would be more fun. See, it's adding to rather than focusing on what I'm not getting in order to get more. Whenever you focus on what you're not getting to get more, then the male just gets less and less and less. So you ask for more from a place of, I'm really very happy, letting him know those are the buffers. I really like this and I like this. For example, my wife wanting me to remember to turn out the light in the bedroom. It comes from a simple statement of 10 years of her complaining about it, mine not changing, her making a big deal out of it, mine saying it's not a big deal. It's just not a big deal in my world. Just anybody who gets upset about the light being on is, we use green energy. You know, you can't rationalize, not even the electric bill, you know. So she has to turn the light out. I say, you don't have to turn the light out. You know, I'll turn it out later if you don't turn it out. So that would be a thorn between us, until finally one day she realized this isn't a big deal. And she came to me and she smiled at me in the kitchen. She said, John, I've noticed you've been turning out the light. I really love that. I took it in. No defensive reaction at all. And then she said, and sometimes you still forget. I just want to remind you how much I appreciate it when you do. Boom, and disappear. Just drop that little request in there in a loving way. No complaining. Always buffer it with a positive statement. And it's not a big deal, but sometimes you still forget. then from that day on, I changed. She did it three times. And then after that, I always turned the light out. And when I turned it out, even today, she's passed. I still think sweet thoughts about her because she asked in such a loving way. Women don't have those skills. This is an art to relationship. Because I know if you don't have that skill, what can you do? You just complain. Then what you don't know is the brain science is that when you use negative emotions to get what you want, in order to get what your brain, in order to feel good, your brain's always looking for things to complain about. And women know that when you're stressed, your mind looks at this and this and this and this and this. It just seems overwhelming. That's your brain. They call it automatic negative complaints. They're going off. You've got ants in your brain, automatic negative thoughts. They're just busy, 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 busy. What's not working? What's not working? What's not working? You can't let go of it. So that's because you've built grooves by using complaints. I complain, I point out what is not working in order to get what I want. And if I do it with emotion of feeling hurt, disappointed, frustrated, worried, complain, all of those emotions create grooves in your brain, literally, so that when you're feeling like I'm not happy, your brain will immediately go to all the things that you're complaining about rather than focusing on, oh, I could ask for this and get it and it would make me happy. So we're training our brain to look at negativity in order to get what we want. In a similar way, let's broaden out the picture for a little wisdom. If you use war to create peace, then how do you create peace? You have to keep making wars. You have to learn how to create peace. You have to learn how to motivate a man. A lot of men are waiting for there to be a fire to put out, and then we have the energy to put it out. And if there's no need that we can fulfill, we have no energy in the relationship. There has to be places where I feel I have a meaningful effect on my wife. And to the extent that she is financially independent, I'm impotent. Unless I understand, and unless she understands that even though she doesn't need my money, she needs my love. And put that into sentences. I need somebody to go on dates with. I need someone to go to the restaurant with. I need someone to sit next to me when I'm having dinner instead of alone at home. I need to lie in bed next to somebody and to cuddle somewhat. I need a partner to have sex with. I need a partner who's got my back. I need to have somebody with me at night so somebody could come and steal from me and mistreat me. I need that. So you need your little guard at home, and you need that companionship, and you need that connection, and you need someone to eat your food with and so forth. And you need someone who thinks you're beautiful, someone who's attracted to you. This just makes you feel a person. So we need men, and men need women. We need each other, and we have these needs. So I actually defined all these needs that women have and men have, and that we often just aren't even aware of. And most importantly, one of the greatest gifts why we're drawn to these heterosexual relationships is there's a masculine energy and a feminine energy. And you create pockets of time where, as a woman, you can reconnect with your feminine energy and he can reconnect with his masculine energy full blown. And that would be making love when you know how to do this. But you have to start outside the bedroom. And then making love is integrating it where I can be strong and soft at the same time. I can feel all this desire for my pleasure, but at the same time, feel totally selfless and loving. You know, this is one of the payoffs of having all these communication skills is making love. And it's not just in the bedroom, but the highest level, at least in my experience, is the bedroom.